Hello, everyone. Welcome to Worldly News. This is the Worldly View, and I'm your host, Killid Shark. And today, we'll be checking out the HexBug Dex Robotics twin set of the Switchfire and the Crossfire blasters. As you can see here, we have the box, and according to its stats, it's for age, has an age rating of 14 to 18 years. It has the manual page of 88 pages. The difficulty is rated a 3 out of 5. And it has over 275 pieces to set things up. And they're both pump action, which means they don't come with any trigger. You just pump the handles and they fire. And I'll even do a quick close-up of the box here for you all to see. As you can see, the Crossfire here is a crossbow that shoots paper airplanes. But they don't come in this color. They come black and white, so you can fill in your own colors. Others can shoot paper airplanes over 9 meters. And the Switchfire can shoot these hard plastic balls up to 6 meters plus. And it shows some alterations they could do. You can have the Switchfire either in the plain barrel and the plain magazine system, or you could do its extended mag with the short barrel, which I highly recommend. And just another reminder there, you can color your own airplanes. Fun fact about this, if you have like a 1/4 inch page hole puncher, you can actually build your own paper airplanes to hook to this system. This tells a lot about the pieces, more about the blasters and stuff and how they work. And it's actually real good. Then inside, I found not only just 2 bags for each blaster that contains all their pieces, but also 2 manuals for the blasters, which go step by step on how to assemble it, and it was easy to follow. And it came with a total of 6 pre-punch-hold paper airplane pages with the designs on here and the lines that indicate where you need to fold the paper airplanes on. So, first things first, I will talk about the Switchfire. Now, right here, the Switchfire is basically a pump action ball shooting device, and it came with 11 of these hard plastic balls. Most in its original setting with the barrel, and the magazine in its original shape could hold up to 7 of these balls. Whereas in this extended mag and short barrel mag configuration, holds up to 10. I actually, for the fun of it, I tried doing an completely extended barrel version in a small mag version. But it would only hold up to 3 to 4 balls in there. And to be honest, the extended barrel doesn't help that well with accuracy or range. So how this works is there's like a set of squeeze prongs, I think I would call it, that actually cause pressure as you pump this back, and it would release the ball. And I will even show you a demonstration just by one simple pump. And once enough pressure has been put onto the ball through the prongs, it will shoot out pretty fast. And one thing that's pretty unique is that it also has slightly longer squeeze prongs here. And it holds the balls in really well in its gravity fed mag. And I actually test these out in the hallway of my condo complex, and the balls, when I fired them from where I was firing from, they went probably maybe roughly 40 feet. I'm not that good at configuring feet to meters, but it could be exactly the same or not. I don't really know how to tell. In fact, why don't I just try to configure it? So, 40 feet divided by 3.25. 12 meters. That can't be right. But I guess it goes over it. Yeah. The one thing about this blaster, I was actually a little bit disappointed. Like, I thought it would be a bit more accurate hit, despite what kind of barrel configuration you used with this. I mean, it looks cool and all. Well, like, one big advantage with this is that you can actually do quick fire like this. And that's another flaw about this project, that toy here. It fires solid, like almost solid ping pong, or really harder than ping pong plastic balls. Like, my sister shot me with this blaster when she came to visit, and it kind of stung a little. Like, not like the Nerf rivals stung feeling, but still stung a little. And it's definitely not safe to shoot at anything like, say, maybe a kid's face, or maybe a expensive TV screen. Definitely would have to be careful where to shoot this thing. So, and honestly, I think the Switchfire, well, it depends on your taste. Maybe there's people out there that would actually love this product. For me, it's like a love-hate kind of blaster. So, moving on the other half of this building kit, we have the Crossfire crossbow and paper airplanes. Now, this kit actually, the one thing that surprised me is it came with like five rubber bands altogether. Two really big ones and three really small ones. And turns out that two of the smaller rubber bands are used to...
who attach the firing mechanism here. So I'll just move the pump up and down a bit, so that way it has some power, some strength against the bowstring here. And the manual gives you a choice. You can either just use one of the rubber band, long rubber bands for the crossbow, or both. So I went with both because it seemed like it would go the distance better. And just with two of these is enough. I would definitely not recommend try and do pull these together. Like, you can't even get past halfway, and it's put a lot of stress on this if you do attempt to do such a thing.
So, how this works is you take one of these bigger airplanes, which comes with these little launch mechanisms, and that these bowstring catchers and locking mechanisms. So I'm just gonna use this one bowstring on here for like, because I'm not going to shoot very far with this right now. You would actually use a hook to hook on the bowstring. You pull it back until you get just to where the trigger mechanism notches are. And right there you have the crossbow ray loaded. Not so fun fact about these blasters is that they don't have any safeties. So definitely don't point this at anyone when it's loaded. And be very, very careful. And I haven't caught my fingers on this yet, but fun fact about crossbows is that if your finger gets in the way of the bowstring, your fingers will most likely get severed or otherwise get cut off by the bowstring because of the amount of strength and speed coming out there. So definitely keep your fingers way below the bow line. So what you would do is you'd take the pump up and you pull it back. Like so, and it's actually much more fun than this blaster. And one thing I did mod on both of these blasters is that I used spare pieces and added like these little triggers over here, because it would be cool to like shoot these single-handed. But it doesn't really work well for this, because first you gotta pump it like this, and then you gotta wait till it gets just the right spot. And then you pull. Okay, that didn't work out at all with this one. So anyway, you would pull like this, and that's it. Like, it doesn't work that well with this. Yes, at all, but for this crossbow, it actually works really well. No, because it's already got a spring, and all you don't really need to push forward on it. You just pull the pump back, and it's basically the same thing with these fingers. Is you go like this. Like, shoot single-handed like this. And for lefties, like, when my sister came over, she actually thought these are really cool little blasters. So, my thoughts to the Crossfire, it's actually better blaster than the Switchfire in my opinion. Mostly because not only can you customize your own paper airplanes like this, yes, but you can also fire the crossbow single-handed like this, instead of just having to pump the blaster. Whereas this one, the only thing you can do is basically just pump like this to keep firing it. So for the twin pack back here, I would definitely recommend it if you got one or two kids that really like shooting with things. But single pack wise, if you were to choose one, I would definitely recommend the Crossfire over the Switchfire, solely on the fact of this crossbow's greater versatility trigger-wise, nice, and its decorativeness. Whereas the Switchfire, it may be versatile in looks and rammed capacity, it's also not that versatile in firing wise. You only can just pump it with, you have to use both hands to do it. So that's my overall review. Would I recommend these products? Well, yes, for the Crossfire. No, not so much on the Switchfire. So that has been another worldly review by Killed Shark. I'm Killed Shark, and hope you all have a good rest of your day.